Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Talk About with Dustin. And since I'm not on the couch in Midian, my game room, I'm in my bedroom. So I figured, I haven't really have a name for this yet, so we'll have to think of something later. But we're going to talk about Gotham by Gaslight, which is the new DC animated Batman movie that just came out a couple days ago. Well, a couple days ago, I think it came out like the 24th or something, but I just watched it tonight. This is the 30th. So, yeah, I will say one thing. I am more impressed with the DC animated movies than I am with the actual movies. I know that's probably backwards for a lot of things, but honestly, the DC animated movies have done a lot better, barring a few that were questionable. The Killing Joke. But they're otherwise pretty good movies. And this is no exception. Now, I haven't read Gotham by Gaslight in a very long time. If you don't know, that's a graphic novel one-shot that came out like in the early 90s. I first read it way back, I'm going to say like 98? I'm not 100% sure. But I do remember the general gist of it. And when I heard about this movie, I honestly forgot about it. I think it was about a year ago when I heard murmurings of it, and I said, oh, I'm going to have to watch that. And then I completely forgot about it until tonight when I seen it, and I was like, oh, crap, you know, buy and watch. But, if you're familiar with the Gotham by Gaslight graphic novel, no worries, because this, while it is an adaptation of it, doesn't really follow it, which is good, because they so throw some things in this movie that is way out of left field that I was like, oh, okay, I see how they're going to do that now. Nice. And I'm not going to spoil the graphic novel or the movie, just in case if you want to try either or. And I think there was a sequel to the graphic novel. I'm not 100%, and I can't be bothered to look it up. But I'm almost positive there was a sequel to it. But this, if you're a Batman fan, is good. It's kind of done in that same Bruce Timverse animation style, but it has a distinctly adult flavor to it, meaning this would be a very hard PG-13 to a light R-rated movie if you're looking in that like kind of scale. A lot of strong language, some questionable things that, you know, you were like, oh, it's a kid's Batman movie. Yeah, kids, enjoy it. Might not want to do that for this particular one. this is definitely geared a little bit towards the adult audience. But very good. Again, if you're worried that it's just going to be a direct adaptation of the graphic novel, it is not. It's very good. I've said that. Very good. It's very good. It's very good. I'm not going to give it a rating like 10 out of 10 or anything like that. It is worth a watch. It is entertaining. It's a lot better than The Killing Joke, which was a bitter disappointment for me. But this is a little bit more. They took the idea of Batman in a Victorian setting and ran with it. And it works. It's really good. If you're a fan of the movie, I highly recommend looking up the graphic novel and seeing if you can find it. It is very good as well. And maybe go into some more of the little darker one-shots of the Batman universe. I would love to see them do something like the Vampire Batman, which is set kind of in the same time period. It's a different altogether, though. But I would love to see that. I think that would be very interesting. And I like the way that they're going so far with these movies. I just wish the DC main movies could be this good. That's really all I wish. It'll probably never happen. But until then, I can make do with the animated movies. Because very good. So yeah, Batman Gotham by Gaslight. Definitely entertaining, worth a watch if you are a fan of Batman. If you're a fan of steampunk, which it's very light steampunk, but it is there. Very good, very good. Highly recommend it. Dustin recommends it. So, yeah, that's it. And just watch it. All right, guys, that's all for tonight. And like as always, try to be better today than you were yesterday. Try to be better tomorrow than you were today. And just don't be dicks to other people. All right, guys, I'll talk to you later. Bye.